in the area where China's Tibet meets countries like Pakistan, India, Nepal, and Bhutan, you'll find the tallest mountain range on Earth, known as the Himalayas. These mountains have stunning peaks, rolling landscapes, and amazing icy views, attracting many adventurers. But did you realize that there's a huge project happening there? China is building a super-long railway tunnel, around 30 kilometers, and these mountains to have modern trains travel through them. For China, this isn't just an ordinary tunnel job. It's a really big challenge for humanity. So, why are they doing this in the Himalayas? And how tough is it to build this tunnel? Thanks for watching the video. If you're interested, why not subscribe to the channel? We can explore more cool projects around the world together. Back on August 8, 2022, Nepal's Foreign Minister Kadgar went to China for a visit. In the report about their talks, Nepal said they want to link up with China across the Himalayas, and that connection is the China-Nepal Railway. But guess what? This railway was actually promised by China's Mao Zedong to Nepal about 40 years ago. It's only recently that both sides seriously thought about making it happen. But why hasn't China built this railway until now? Well, the China-Nepal Railway is the hardest railway project worldwide. It's in an area where earthquakes happen and glaciers are found in the Himalayas. During construction, they might face bad weather and landslides, which makes building it really, really tough. Scientists who explored the area found that in the past few years, more than 1,000 landslides happened along the railway route. Sometimes, there's one landslide for every kilometer. This makes building the China-Nepal Railway really complicated. They need super advanced methods and smart designs to keep everything safe and well-built. But in the past, both China and Nepal didn't have enough tech or money to do it. But by 2022, China got better at building things and had more technology. So, they decided to give Nepal around $4.3 billion to help build the China-Nepal Railway. This railway will extend the Qinghai-Tibet Railway, which is part of China's Qinghai-Tibet line, into Nepal. The China-Nepal Railway is a big project that will make a train line from China to Nepal. The whole train track will be about 540 kilometers long, starting from a place called Zaiges in China and going to the capital of Nepal, Kathmandu. They're planning to work on building this railway for about 10 years. But what's really amazing is that most of the railway, about 98%, will be made up of bridges and tunnels. That's like 530 kilometers in total. And out of these tunnels, 45 of them go through the big mountains known as the Himalayas. The hardest part of building this railway is where it has to go through a mountain range called the Mala Mountains. So, the engineers from China are trying to make a super long tunnel through these mountains. This is what we're going to talk about today, the Himalayas Tunnel. You know, the Himalayas are the tallest mountains in the world, and not many people live there. If we want to build things there, it's really tough. But to make the China-Nepal Railway work through these mountains, China started building the Himalayas Tunnel in February 2023. They've been working really hard, and they've already made a tunnel that's 1680 meters long in just 5 months. If countries like the United States or Germany did this, it might take almost a year to achieve what China did in 5 months. But there's still a lot to do. The Chinese team has only finished a small part of the tunnel, about 1/30th of it. The whole tunnel will be around 30 kilometers long. China will spend more than $1.4 billion to finish it, and each kilometer will cost around $46 million. Interestingly, if we compare this to the Gatwick Tunnel, which is the longest railway tunnel in the world, the cost of building the Himalayas Tunnel is much lower. The Gatwick Tunnel cost about $198 million for each kilometer. This shows that China's projects are bigger and cheaper than those of other countries. But even though China is making good progress, they're not done yet. They think they'll finish the Himalayas Tunnel before December 2024 if everything goes as planned. Building such a long tunnel is really tough. First, the tunnel is in a very high and cold place. And in high places like this, there's not much oxygen in the air. People who study these things say that the air at places higher than 4,800 meters has less than half the oxygen as lower places. So, for the Himalayas tunnel to be finished, the workers need to have enough oxygen to do their job, and they use special machines to make sure they have enough. To help build things faster, China sent a huge machine called the Jihua Shield to work on a big tunnel project. This machine, made in China, is the biggest of its kind and has a diameter as wide as 16.07 meters. It's so heavy that it weighs 4,300 tons. This machine can dig a really tall tunnel section all at once, almost like six floors stacked on top of each other. It's super important for the Himalayas tunnel project. The Jihua Shield machine uses a special part called the machine head to dig into the ground. At the same time, it has sharp blades that cut through the dirt. The machine takes away the dirt using a moving belt. As the machine moves forward, it's supported by things like concrete walls, metal sheets, and steel arches. The machine also checks the ground and predicts what might happen to keep the workers safe. For moving building stuff and things people need to live, China's workers have to use roads. But in places high up in the mountains, this is really dangerous. Imagine driving on a road that's really high in the air. It's even harder because the building site is in a faraway mountain area. A while back, when they were building the Qinghai-Tibet Railway, over 100 people sadly died in a car accident while carrying stuff on the road. The air pressure is different up there, and that makes the tires often burst. So, moving things is a big problem for this new project. So, why is China spending so much money to build the China-Nepal Railway? Well, China and Nepal have been good friends for a long time. They became friends about 40 years ago and have helped each other. Nepal has also been connected to India in its history. Once, China's leader, Chairman Mao, told visitors from Nepal that they don't need to worry about India when the road is fixed. Now, China is really good at building things and has good technology. China also wants to keep a promise it made to Nepal a long time ago. Do you know why the China-Nepal Railway is really important for China? It's not just about helping Nepal become better. There's another big reason. China is thinking about how countries in South Asia work together. Because of the big mountains called the Himalayas, China has been far away from India. When the China-Nepal Railway is finished, it will be a huge deal. It will connect China to India and even reach the Bay of Bengal. This means there will be a way to send things by the sea without going around the bay. In the future, the China-Nepal Railway will connect with trains from Southeast Asian countries and India. China is also planning a big project called the Trans-Asian Railway. This project will connect many countries in Asia by train, starting from Kunming and going all the way to the Eurasian Railway Network. After this well-thought-out plan comes into action, China will have a safe and efficient land road. This road will help China rely less on moving things by sea, especially in tough situations. At the same time, this plan will also make things smoother between countries in South Asia. Thinking about how countries affect each other, the China-Nepal Railway could make Nepal less controlled by India. It could also become a really important spot for China to handle its relationship with India. And that's the end of what we wanted to share in this video. If you have different ideas about this plan, we'd love you to put them in the comments. Let's have a good talk. And make sure you subscribe to our channel, because we're going on a cool journey to learn about more awesome projects and things that happen in the future.